everybody, Dan Jablons here from Retail Smart Guys, and excited to do this video for you about the vendor scorecard. Now, let me tell you a little bit about the vendor scorecard, how it started. I didn't invent it, per se. The way it happened was I was working, as many of you know, I started my career working for a children's clothing manufacturer, and we worked with some fairly giant names in the retail industry. And that's where I learned about the vendor scorecard. Some of the bigger players that we worked with would give us a vendor scorecard at the end of every season. And they would basically give us some stats they expected us to live up to. And because they were who they were, they would say, these are the stats. And if you, if you're above the department average, we'll see you next season. If not, well, we'll decide what we're going to do, right? So that's how they viewed it. I'm not necessarily advocating that, but that's kind of where it started. So when I learned about that, when I first got into independent retail and was working for a point-of-sale distributor, I actually brought the vendor scorecard with me from that world into this world. So that's how I kind of got started in this whole thing. The idea behind the vendor scorecard is really, it's a lot like a report card that kids get in school, right? The idea is to see, where do we do well? What did we not do well? Why did it happen? And what should we do going forward? And so I don't want you to think of the vendor scorecard as just an opportunity to beat up a vendor, because it's not meant to be that. It's meant to be, these are places we did well, these are places we didn't do well. And if there are places that we did well and could do better, we should be able to find those too. And if there are places that we didn't do well, we have to look at the reasons why. What is it that we did there? Why didn't it go so well? And what can we do to do better going forward? So that's about as much as I want to tell you generally about the vendor scorecard. I think it's worth taking a deep dive into it, looking at it, and let's just see how you might apply this to your business. So let's take a look at a vendor scorecard.
All right, before I show you a vendor scorecard, I think it's important to have a discussion about cash margin. So look at this with me for a moment. Cash margin is a little different than gross margin or even maintained markup because it measures your sales against what you spent, what you bought from the vendor. Okay, it's a little different. So think about this for a moment. Let's just say you work with a vendor and you buy $1,000 at cost from that vendor. That's what line one is. The initial purchase is $1,000. Okay, and let's just say you were planning to put those goods out at $2,200, right? A 2.2 markup, not anything particularly aggressive or crazy or greedy or anything like that. Buying goods for $1,000, putting it up for $2,200, not uncommon. Okay, that means that the planned margin, the planned amount of money you expected to gain from this was $1,200, right? The $2,200 minus the $1,000. Okay, what actually happens? Well, actually, we only sell $1,700. Why? Well, not all of it sold, had to take some markdowns, maybe we gave some away, maybe some of it got damaged by my staff or something like that, right? Any of that is possible. So we only sell $1,700. Now that means that my actual cash margin is my actual sale, $1,700, minus line one, which is my initial purchase. So my actual cash margin is $700. Now if you think about that $700, that's the net change to your bank account, right? You wrote checks to vendors for $1,000, and you got cash or credit cards or whatever from your customers of $1,700, so the net is $700. Okay, now that means that I didn't get the $1,200 I'd hoped for. I only got $700. I'm $500 short on my cash margin. So cash margin looks at your sales at retail minus your receiving at cost. So sales at retail minus receiving at cost. Super important concept. Okay, all right. Now that we have that down, let's take a look at a vendor scorecard. Okay, here's a vendor scorecard, and it's semi-based on some real data from an actual customer, but I changed a lot of things so that it would be very anonymous. So it's sort of a sample, all right? Now, the way this is organized is you can see that the first column here is all of the departments that we buy from this particular vendor. The second column is the style information. Now, that's as far as this goes. Some people like to put size and color in there. I don't always do that. I like to at least just have it to style level just so you can get a high level view of it. But sometimes it is helpful to at least put color in there. But for the purposes of this demonstration, let's just do department and we'll do style. Okay. Now, the next four columns are receiving. So it's receiving units. How many units did I buy from that vendor? What was my initial retail? What did I plan to put the goods out at? What's my initial cost and my initial markup? Okay. The next four columns after that is what did I sell it at? So how many units did I sell? What was my final retail after discounts? Okay, the cost of the goods I sold, and my final margins. And then the last four columns are, well, what's left over? What do I have on hand in units? What's the current retail of the goods that I have on hand? What's the current cost of the goods I have on hand? And the margins of the goods that I have on hand. All right, now, when you look at this report, you'll also notice that it stops in its subtotals by each individual department, which is important. Now, the reason why the dollars are important as you look at this is like here I am looking at my casual dresses, right? So I landed 28 pieces and I sold 21 of those. And you might think, okay, well, that's, you know, a 75% sell-through, not so bad, right? That said, okay, I bought them at a 54% markup, okay? But I ended up selling them at a 37% markup, didn't I, right? So I had to take some big markdowns to get to that moment. Okay, so it's important to look at not only how many units did I sell, but also what's the retail I'm selling it at. Okay, now, here's another one. I sold halfway through these dresses, which are my formal dresses, but at least I maintained margin a little bit here. Here's jackets. Look at this one. I received six, I sold five, and I maintained margin the whole way. Okay, and I only have one left. And the idea of this is to work with your vendor to see where did you do well and where didn't you do well, okay? In this case, you know, I didn't buy that many jackets, but I sure did great with them. I sold through almost all of them, and I maintained margin on all of them. In my casual dresses, yeah, I sold 3/4 of them, but boy, I had to take some big markdowns, especially here and here and here, right? I took some pretty rough markdowns in those. So maybe I bought too many casual dresses from them and I didn't actually give them a chance to shine as well as I could have in jackets. Same is kind of true in sweaters, okay? And in sweaters, you know what? This top one, I sold through every piece, but I didn't do so well. This one, you know what? The crop one, well, I sold through most of it, but again, I held margin, right? There's a lot of lessons to learn in this. So maybe I don't give this vendor enough of a chance to shine in jackets. Maybe I should have bought more sweaters. And certainly, I didn't need to buy as many dresses as I bought. Now, look at the bottom of this report, because this is where the discussion really should begin, and then you actually go into each of those categories, right? First, there's my planned margin. And the math is here for you to look at, right? I spent $79.45 with that vendor. That's what I received at cost, okay? It's $79.45. Hoping for 17,416 or a 54.38% margin, right? So 94.71 is this number minus this number, and you can see the math right there. Okay. Well, what actually happened? I only sold 11,446. So my actual cash margin is 11,446 minus the 7.95, because those are the things that actually happened in my bank account, right? I wrote him checks for 79.45. And my customers gave me cash and credit cards for $11,446. So my netted cash was $3,501. And you can see the math there again, right? Which means that cash margin wise, I was hoping for $94.71. I only got $3,501. So I'm short $59.70. Now, this is the document you can give to a vendor and say, this is our result. What can we do?
All right, now that you've seen the vendor scorecard, let's talk a little bit about what you might do with it, okay? So after you've been through all of the things in terms of the numbers that are on the vendor scorecard that I just showed you, I think the best thing to do is to show that vendor scorecard, show the differences in the cash margin, and turn to the vendor and say, what can you do for me? Sometimes you have to say, look, I know you probably can't make this call while we're sitting here. Take this piece of paper back with you, show it to your management, and tell me what you want to do. Now, a lot of times, there are vendors that say, we won't do anything, right? And that's their right. They can certainly say that to you. If they do, if they just say they won't do anything, that doesn't mean you don't buy from them. It just means that whatever you buy, you're 100% going to have to take the hit on, right? If you take a markdown, it's all on you. They're not taking it back. They're not adjusting. They're not helping. They're not doing anything. So you just have to know that when you buy their line and buy it cautiously, if you feel their line is critical to your store. Right? That's important. But if there are things that they can do for you, what can they do? Well, certainly they can do things like give you free freight. They can certainly take some goods back. They can help sponsor markdowns. They could sponsor sales contests. They could give you more time on some outstanding invoices, give you better terms for invoices going forward. There's a lot they might do to help you if they see that the cash margin that you were hoping for, you didn't get. It is important to talk to those vendors about what you did do to salvage the situation. Maybe you promoted it heavily on social media. Maybe you moved the goods around in the floor. Maybe you talked to your salespeople and gave them some spiffs to try and sell the goods. Talk about the things you did to make the situation better so you're not just coming to them with your hat in your hand, crying and saying it didn't work. Talk about what you did as a retail professional to try to get through these goods, okay? After that, if it doesn't work, then let's see what they'll do to help you, okay? Now, your better vendors should welcome the vendor scorecard, okay? They should look at it as an opportunity to improve their business inside your store. So watch for that, too. If they like it, you know you've got a good vendor or a good rep on your hands. And if they regret it, then you don't have such a great rep or such a great vendor, okay? A lot of times, vendors, I can tell you this, when I was a vendor, want this information because they have to go to meetings where they're going to talk about what they're going to produce in the upcoming seasons. And it's always great information for them to have, or for me when I was a rep, for me to have, so when I went to that meeting, I could talk about what my clients were doing. So I was actually very happy to get the vendor scorecards when we got them in. So their better vendors should welcome it. They should want it. But here's the other thing I think is interesting. When the vendor knows that there's going to be a vendor scorecard at the end of every season, I find they view it differently. They actually, when they present the line to you, they present the line knowing that there's going to be a vendor scorecard at the end of it. So they're not just going to throw everything at you and hope to get a bigger order. They're going to throw the things at you that they think will sell well so that when they get that vendor scorecard, everybody's happy and everybody's looking forward to the next season and they can keep their business going with you. I think that's an important thing that vendors will do. Okay? So here's the thing. This vendor scorecard is a very valuable tool. Now, if you've got one in your point of sale system, great. If you don't have one, reach out to us and we'll help you build it. If you're not on planning, then we'll help you put it there and we'll do it for free if you jump onto planning. If you are on planning with us, then talk to me or any of the other retail smart guys about it and we'll help you get it put together. All right. I hope this video was helpful to you. I think it's a super important tool. I think it's something you want to use every time you talk to your major vendors, every time you go to major trade shows, every time you finish a season, every time you start to evaluate what you're doing for the next season, so that you are a better buyer, you're working much more closely with your vendors as partners, and that you get better sell-through, better margins, and better cash flow. Again, Dan Jablons from Retail Smart Guys here to help you. Here's my contact information. That's my cell phone over there as well as my email address. Certainly write to me, call me, and I'm here to help you, as are all the members of Retail Smart Guys, and we hope you have a great day.